So as of right now, I'm working on building the most efficient camera setup dream team. At the moment, I have two lenses. Both of them are pretty fast. And the camera I shoot with has a full frame sensor, which means when I'm shooting in the dark, for the most part, most of the things that I come up with should look pretty good. So I'm gonna take you through how I try and shoot the cleanest low light footage as possible. Before we even start, you need to know how to expose. Because sometimes you can get really bad artifacts and noise when you shoot and it's not exposed properly. Meaning there's not that much separation from what's in focus and what's in the background. So the first thing I do is turn on the histogram. It's like a guide showing how much of the image is in the shadows and how much of it is in the highlights. I try and adjust my settings and make it spread out instead of it all just sort of being in the dark. And if you want to avoid noise when shooting in low light, you might want to know about base ISO, and I only recently found out about this. So to keep it simple, base ISO is the ISO setting you get the least amount of noise and grain possible. There's a lot of science and technicalities to it. When you match your settings to the base ISO, you're basically setting your camera up to get the least amount of noise possible, virtually zero, and something very, very hard for the human eye to spot. And be sure to use small portable lighting, which I've actually been using for the whole of this video. But there's literally only so much I can show you here, so here's my bag, and I'll take you guys along with me, man. Alright, I have to stay cozy now. So when I'm out, I try and use free lighting as much as possible. Usually if you're shooting in a city or some sort of town, there'll be some sort of light near you, your storefront, a street light, or even traffic lights. Let me show you guys the type of shots we got. Alright. Laptop right here. Now we got the footage, we need to make it look presentable. So I've added a couple notes here. First thing to do is to like color correct it to make sure that the blacks are actually black and the whites and the highlights actually stay white. This is cool, but this is looking like mad like red. Oh no, it's just looking a bit red. It's looking a bit too red for my liking. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna go into the first node. I'm gonna click on the curves. I'm going to go to red. I'm gonna color correct this to make it look closer to kind of what I want. So I'm gonna take out some of the red in the shadows. Cool. Now that's looking a bit better. So I've taken out some of the red in the shadows. I think this was shot on second base ISO. I think 12800. Especially when you're shooting at night and at dark, there's a lot of weird color in the shadows. So cool, now that I've color corrected the shadows, I'm gonna try and like keep the whites really white and the darks really black and really dark. Cool. And I'm gonna click on the dark part here, and I'm just desaturate. So that's basically keeping the blacks really, really black. And then on my head to here, click on the whitest part of the image, probably like here. And then I'm gonna desaturate that. So we don't have any sort of weird colors in the shadows or in the highlights. Next, I'm gonna add some sharpness. Cause I'm shooting on like fast lenses. Sometimes there's a lot of blur. So sometimes it does get a little more blurry than it should. And like, it looks a bit too blurry. And then I'm gonna just add some, just make it a bit more sharp. There we go, that looks really good. Put down the highlights a bit. So yeah, that is how I try and get the best low light. Is that a power cut? Cool, I guess that's the end of the vid. I appreciate anyone that's tapped in, and yeah, new video next week as always. Cool, let me go try fix this.